Still a little too quiet. this is my third trip here to Strum Shop, and I'm really cool to be back again, and I want to thank the folks here at this Strum Shop. I don't know how many of you were here for my my workshop earlier, but Stu was telling me that I was the very first person to perform here. We had a slack key festival a few years back, and it was an honor to open for some of the legends in slack key guitar. Go Reverend Dennis Kamakahi, who we lost last year, and then also Kavika Kahiapo, and then who else was on that show? LT Smooth was on that show. It was all great, incredible slack key players, and I opened up that show. It was a lot of good fun. We were all distracted by all the cool guitars on the wall and the ukuleles. It's always bad when you stick musicians in a room where there's things you can buy. So I play the style of guitar that I play is called kiho alu, or slack key guitar is more commonly known. And kiho alu literally translates into loosen the keys. And it's a style of guitar that goes way back and originates in Hawaii. And it was brought to Hawaii by the vaqueros, so the Mexican cowboys from here, actually, when this whole area used to be Mexico at one point. And King Kamehameha III had commissioned or hired some of the vaqueros, so the Espaniola, from here to teach us Hawaiians how to put cattle and horses in manageable places, because we didn't know how to do that stuff, and we didn't know how to ride horses and use ropes and things like that. So they hired the Mexican vaqueros over, and they taught us how to do all that stuff, and they also brought with them the guitar to Hawaii, and showed us what this incredible instrument can do. And what they didn't do is teach us how to tune it. And so, adventurous Hawaiians came up with their own tunings and tuned it to originally to an open G chord. That's what sounds nice when you strum an open tune guitar. And from that came hundreds and hundreds of different tunings. And at one time, it was actually in art form that was in danger of being lost, if it wasn't for folks like Uncle Gabby Pahinui, the Hawaiian Renaissance, Keola Beamer, who kind of Sonny Chillingsworth, Ata Isaacs, naming all these folks who we kind of owe to this music still being here. If not for them, then we would have lost this valuable art form, because there's a highly guarded secret, some of these tunings that they would use. Now we have YouTube, and you can find these tunings just by searching slack key, and it's right there. This song is a little bit different tuning from the first one I did. Bad part about slack key is you're constantly having to tweak it. This song's one of my favorite songs. Talks about a place over on Hawaii Island, and one of my favorite places is a place called Kailua Kona. Anybody from there? Been there? Kailua Kona? Two people? Been there? Been there, okay. Well, I was almost having to change songs after I built it up. And this song talks about the many visitors that this place gets every year, a beautiful place called Kailua Kona. Still beautiful after the Costco that they put in there. Traffic though, like any other place, the Costco. Oh, hey. Nakag-econ na. Nabigyan na naman ako. Mahalo. Thank you. I'm gonna make a slight adjustment. My guitar keeps slipping, so at one point I was like playing like this. So I'm gonna grab my strap over here. I think I'd like to bring up these beautiful hula dancers that I told you about earlier, and I'm gonna feature a song from the beautiful island of Maui, a beautiful place called Lahaina Town. You guys here know that place, Lahaina. Well, this song is a little subdivision of Lahaina called Pua Mana, and throwing hints out there to see who dances this one. I'll go ahead and bring them up. Big round of applause for dancing with Harold and Sylvia. One of the worst things you can do is invite hula dancers up and then tune. While they stand there. And I'm just gonna tell like a little bit about this. This song is written by Auntie Ermgard, another very prolific Hawaiian songwriter. And this song is talks about this little section right there in Lahaina. They used to have a property right on the beach on the coast. And she, Auntie Ermgard actually planted a coconut tree when it was really little, right along the coast there, for each one of her mo'opuna, her grandchildren. And those little coconut trees turned out to be very tall, big coconut trees, which you can still see today if we go over there into Pua Mana. And it talks about this little area, and I think the second verse of the song, beautiful song called Pua Mana. Hurry up. Cool money. Best part about being a Hawaiian musician. Don't tell my wife I said that. Actually, these beautiful dancers are my wife's hula sisters. My wife also dances for Halo Kekeli'i over in the South San Francisco area. And they all know my wife. And probably
we love her.
Love her? And they are watching me. Tuning again. Into one of my favorite classic Hawaiian songs, and a song that famous by Israel Kamakawiwa. They also, Auntie Genoa Keawe did this song years before that. One of my favorite songs called Hene Hene Koaka. Trying to decide how I want to play it though. Just did a workshop earlier on strumming in different rhythms, and I have all these rhythms going through my head. I'm gonna take off my Fitbit. You guys know what a Fitbit is? It's this really cool device that tracks your steps, and so makes you feel healthy if you look at the app and track how many steps you've taken throughout the day. And I found out a way that you can trick it, is if you play ukulele, you can shoot a lot of miles that way. So I'm like, wow, I walked 30,000 steps today? Like, I didn't realize I walked that far. But you shouldn't trick it, you should actually walk that much. So go ahead, hene hene koaka. Thank you.